Now, thank you, Jaliat Namuwaya, for that report. Now, in a related story, the Parliamentary Committee on Defence and Internal Affairs has been directed by the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, to go to Masaka and investigate the heightened incidents of murders in which 26 people have been killed in just a space of 1 month. Now, Parliament today debated a report over the spate of murders in Masaka, which has left, which was tabled by the Minister of State for Internal Affairs, General David Muhoozi, with MPs expressing displeasure with the efforts currently undertaken by the government to arrest the situation. We have the details in the following report.
The Minister of State for Internal Affairs, General David Muhoozi, today presented a report on the heightened incidence of murders in Greater Masaka region to Parliament, indicating a death toll of 26 people in the space of less than a month, with 69 suspects arrested. 11 suspects are already prosecuted as others are being screened.
Rampant killings have indeed taken place in Luengo district and also some in Masaka district from the months of June to about yesterday but one, where the country this far has lost 26 precious lives as follows. On the 5th of July 2021, at Kenangasi village, Chiseka sub-county, Luengo district, one Kawesi Kasim, aged 50 years, was murdered by unknown assailants.
Muhoozi connected the serial killings to terrorism, saying murderers are not motivated by property gains since they take nothing from the victims.
Whatever the motive, the intended effect has been to cause fear, terror and apprehension in the public. They use the same killing method of hitting the victims on the head with blunt objects, and the killings have been in large measure indiscriminate, except for the last ones, which were mainly targeting old people. The pattern of killing is also similar, timings mainly between 2000 hours and 2200 hours at night.
The report incited criticism from members of parliament who castigated its scope, maintaining that people who have been hacked to death but their names are missing on the minister's list.
I have not heard Sebanakita James from Chitanga, whose CBR is 445/2021, and the other two people that were murdered also in Chitanga. I have not heard, Honourable Minister, from you that these people are now burning houses in the night. 3 days ago, they burnt houses in Inkoni Parish.
Honourable Minister, I want to inform you that the information you've given is not substantive, like my colleague, Dr. Abedi, has mentioned. Let me inform you that yesterday, at around 13 hours, there was a gentleman by names of Peter Kivumbi, a 36-year-old from Bunyere Degea, who was dissected half dead and is currently lying in Masaka Hospital.
Others castigated the breakdown of intelligence services in the country, where officials in intelligence network lack adequate skills and capacity to arrest the situation.
Honourable Minister, when you tell us that we should run after the killers and bring them to book, why don't we first talk about the breakdown in this system? How can we have all these officers who are supposed to detect and have this intelligence provided to government before anything happens fail to detect until we lose 26 people? To me, I think there's something we need to discuss as government.
I think our intelligence is lacking, particularly when it comes to the policemen. Long time ago, you would find a policeman, for example, the intelligence in the community, and the community would not even know that they are actual intelligence. But we have now a system where the DISO comes and introduces himself as a DISO. The PISO introduces himself as a DISO. And the intelligence officer introduces themselves in a meeting as intelligence officers. So you cannot curb, you cannot mitigate.
Legislators believe the massacre in Masaka has not been given the attention it deserves, citing poor facilitation of security agencies in the area, where several police posts lack funds to fuel patrol motorcycles and vehicles.
We informed the Minister for Security, because Dr. Abedi Bwanika and other colleagues moved, Honorable Kakande and others, to meet with the community and security leaders. And they were informed that we are hardly facilitated. We have no fuel. The motorcycles are grounded. Personnel is non-existent.
MPs are concerned that security is unevenly distributed across the country, which has exposed some parts of the country with a deficit to insecurity.
This matter is emotional. That while in other areas you will have people grazing with the AK-47, in our area people are being butchered, and those whose duty it is to protect them are in Kampala. To the minister and other members, if this problem was somewhere else outside of Uganda, outside Masaka, would you take the same attention?
Stop seeing this happen.
Stop being tribalistic.
We have security officers almost camped everywhere in the city. We have too many soldiers, more than the number of fish on the lakes of Victoria. And to give this as evidence, Madam Speaker and my colleagues, last week I witnessed when the unfishery soldiers were burning nets and boats. I therefore would like to inform the country and request General Internal Affairs Minister that those soldiers that are too much keeping the fish should go and keep the people of Great Masaka.
Story by Fred Kajubi for the news at Parliament.